option. The outbreak of madness on the Titania was caused by Albert's presence. The crew exiled him on the lockboat to stop it. Oh no. Which, wait. Albert Throgmorton was the source of the madness that made Titanic crew fight each other. Shit, that's the link. Okay, let's go talk to this guy one more time. Let's go talk to Nick's hubby. He's Hispando.
You see now, oh, do you?
Okay.
The splendid horror of the truth.
That looks weird. I'm just gonna take a snapshot at the Cthulhu over here. Maybe Throgmorton might be able to know what that is, if it works. That is something. Definitely so is that. Alright, let's head back. I don't know how to save these people, though. That's the thing. Like, can we just tell the local officials, like, hey, we gotta go down and pick them up. There's only two alive. Three alive. Everybody else is either dead or dying.
Gods lean over us.
Can take a walk yet.
I'm not finished here yet.
Or I'm not finished here yet.
The scientists didn't even take their tools with them.
So, what am I missing? Is there something in the other vision that I'm not seeing?
Sancta Mare, be our eyes. Eyes to see the distant stars.
Oh, that would do it.
A perfectly preserved artifact. Was it the focus of their worship?
There it is. What happened here?
We enter the temple the moment they take the key seal. Get ready to cut up their diving suits.
Ooh. Same group as before. Oh, damn it. I guess it's too far out of that.
Forget them. Get the seed and the seal now.
Okay. What? It's shivering. This is... No! Get away from me!
I think I'm starting to get the picture.
I want to say it's going to start with that one and then these two.
What? It's shivering. This is...
We enter the temple the moment they... Forget them! Get the seed and the seal now!
Nope. Okay, so it's just... It's very linear. Okay.
Temple, the moment. Forget them. Get the seed and...
Okay? What? It's shivering. This is... No! Get away from me!
No, it's not.
Forget him! Get the seed and the seal now!
Okay? What? It's shivering.
See, this feels like it's the first thing.
We enter the temple the moment they take the key seal. Get ready to cut up their diving suits. Forget them! Get the seed and the seal now!
I don't think this will work.
Okay? What? It's shivering. This-
We enter- into the temple the moment they take the key seal.
So it should go 1, 2, 3, right?
Okay. What? It's shivering. This is... No!
We enter the temple the moment they take... Forget them! Get the seed and the seal now!
Okay, let's try the other way.
Okay. What?
Forget them! Get the seed and the... We enter the temple the moment they take the key seal. Get ready to cut up their diving suits.
And there's not another option, right? That I'm not seeing? No? No? We cut their suits as soon as they enter in. What's this one again?
Forget them! Get the seed and the seal now!
That's gotta be the last one, right?
We enter the temple the moment they take the key seal. Get ready to cut up their diving suit.
Okay. What? It's shiver.
Forget them! Get the seed and the seal now!
There we go.
The expedition found an artifact that drove them mad. Then the Innsmouthers stole it and the professor in one go.
Brain parasites, chat. Let me go talk to the guy one more time. He might have something.
You see
nope.
Now, do you?
Damn it. Okay. You should be able to leave and then go to Throgmorton and kind of explain the situation. It's like, yeah, the doc's been kidnapped. Yep, there we go. Oh, that's handy. Okay, so that's why you got rid of the, Isn't that bad for your body, though? Depressurization's gonna suck. Or it's not, and he's gonna take it like a badass. All right. Or not. Get it out of my hand. See, why did you have to touch it? Don't touch something if you don't know what it is yet. Or have somebody else touch it. And then see what happens to them. Through that backdrop almost looks painted. Think that would be a good time to probably go see Throgmorton? Yeah?
Never again, they say.
Ooh. My diary part 2. The doctors at the Boston Asylum were looking for a way to fix me, proved to be a tall order. At first they asked me questions. I thought my story would be reported to the officials, but they were just making a list of things to fix. I feared water, so they swaddled me in the drenched sheets. I told them about the things in the darkness, so they kept me in dark rooms, blindfolded. No progress until they brought the electrodes. They kept my thoughts jumbled. Only the words of the doctor held my mind together. He told me who I am and how to think. He gave me concoctions to keep me sane. Seems I'm getting used to it. Question is, for better or for worse. Any new outfits? Unlock my story progress. Man, I really want the investigator pack. That just looks so good. That night. Oh, unlock by DLC. Collect all the mystic tomes. I guess there is DLC already for the game. Whoa, wait a minute. Who would leave a note? You look so silly in that hat, newcomer. I think I'll keep it along with your scalp. Man, my neighbors are so nice, chat. I mean, oh my god. So nice. Yeah?
The door won't budge.
Damn. As far as I can tell, yeah.
I'm watching you, newcomer.
Yeah, I think that thing's watching you, so I think we're fair. And I feel like you need a lot of alcohol to stay at this place. A lot of alcohol. Alright. So I'm thinking... underwater artifact. The Innsmouthers know the truth about this madness. They need an artifact and Herod, the one who took it. Which means... I have to save the expedition. I must tell Robert where the survivors are and start searching for Harriet. Which means we can go to Throgmorton right now. Which is... that's the asylum. Where is old Throggy? Oh, you're up all the way to the south, aren't you? Fastest way to probably... would be to take this... over. And head on. I do love the outfits though in the game. That's a nice touch. It's a real nice touch. Treasure! Is that north? That's north, right? There we go. I love how the cult guys are walking around in outfits made out of human flesh, and yet nobody bats an eye. Not even in the slightest. Can I not, oh yeah, no, there we go. Hi. I'm just gonna... okay, you can't jump it. Didn't know. That's okay, I'm leaving anyway. Hi, guys. Whoop, whoop. Okay, so I'm gonna put a little note here. Locked. There is a boat access over here, though. It's up since 5 p.m. All right, Fade, you take it easy. Thank you for stopping by. Hope you have a good day. About a shitty area, holy crap. Woo, throw the needle. Mr. Morton, to my left. Throgmorton, sorry. One more. I really don't suppose you don't have a, oh, you do. Okay, good. I was gonna say, there should be a, phone booth around here somewhere. I'd be inside, actually. He's rich enough. In loving memory, Albert Throgmorton, son of respected Robert Throgmorton, and descendant of a robust bloodline, died on Thursday at Oakmont Port, age 25. We mourn his untimely death, but we celebrate the way he lived his life. The Throgmorton family appreciates the many comforting words and prayers sent by the citizens. All right, there is a... At least there was a phone booth.
Bad news, Mr. Throgmorton. The expedition members are dead, and the Innsmouthers kidnapped the professor.
But I want to watch him. I'm sleepy. Okay.
They dare get in my way.
Your expedition found something buried in the ruins.
It is a good game, though.
The Innsmouthers were after it. They captured Professor Dell, along with the artifact she was carrying.
Artifact? What artifact? Where did you find them? Tell me everything.
Your men found some kind of underwater temple. In it was an ancient artifact. The Innsmouthers call it the Seal. The Innsmouthers were lying in wait. Your men took the item, and the Innsmouthers took their chance and made off with Professor Dell and the artifact.
How did they catch them off guard?
Seems that after the seal was taken from its place, everyone in the expedition suffered some kind of mental breakdown. The Innsmouthers must have known about that and waited for the right moment.
They knew what was going to happen. Inconceivable. Wait a moment, how did you know they were Innsmouthers?
One of the attackers was killed by a member of the expedition. I have a photo.
My expedition failed. My boy was killed. This is more than personal, Mr. Reed. This is a threat to everyone.
They have Harriet and the artifact she found, but she may still be alive.
That's why I hesitate to wipe their fish-faced kin from Oakmont this instant. But we won't sit idle. Find them, Mr. Reed. Not the grunts, but their leaders. Infiltrate their ranks if need be. Bring me my professor back.
This man's got an awesome voice. I'm just gonna say, he got awesome voice.
I'm looking into the madness, not politics and power games.
And your best source of information is currently in the slimy hands of those Innsmouthers. Professor Doe shared the visions. She found something inside those ruins, and now they have her. She knows something crucial, I'm certain. There's also a more delicate matter I wanted to discuss with you, Mr. Reed.
I can be delicate when it matters, so shoot.
I have a colleague, you might say. His name is Herbert Glover. Like myself, he is a collector of fine art.
I'm a detective, Mr. Throgmorton, not a burglar.
I don't care for your insinuation, Mr. Reed. I would never be so crass as to hire a thief. I had a meeting arranged with Herbert. One of great importance, shall we say. One at which he failed to appear. I want you to find out why.
That sounds simple enough. Okay, I'll do it.
Very good, Mr. Reed. There is one final detail. This case must remain secret, and you must not reveal to anyone for whom you are working.
Discretion is my watchword.
Indeed. Here is Herbert's address in an advance for your investigation. You'll find it's fair.
Have a good day.
Ooh, I got a knowledge point? What is a knowledge point? Oh, apparently I have been leveling up and I did not even realize it. Okay. Biscuits. Keep an extra bolt loaded, gaining a chance to deal double damage with a pistol. 10% chance. Carry more pistol bullets. Unnatural, when close to death, slowly regenerate a limited amount of health for one lasting fighting chance. Falling from heights deals half damage. Man-eating eels deal half damage while swimming. Vitality increases, your vitality increases. Your melee does more damage. Okay, that's the one that we want to work on, chat. But let me take a look at the others, just in case. Carry up to 25 pieces of crafted material. 50% chance to save materials when crafting first aid kits, sanity kits, and traps. Ooh, that's really good, actually. Okay. Alright, some of these are really good. and stay sane for slightly longer. I'm gonna go with melee, because right now that's my big issue, is melee. So now I hit like a truck. I prefer the fish faces. That dude just looks weird and trying to be normal. I know it does, but his voice is just so awesome. Like, so awesome. Whoa. Oh, I guess it took the back way. All right. He sounds like the perfect villain that you expect him to be, but at the same time, I'm not entirely too sure he is. He might just be one of those people that just kind of rides that gray line, right? Quid pro quo. So I actually did complete cases. As far as I can tell, I didn't flub them up. Cool. I honestly expected me to flub most of this up just horribly, because we stuck it on Master Sleuth. There's no clues. There's no indicators. It's like, go figure it out. Normally, I don't do good at figuring out things. I'm just kind of like, I ramble on until something happens. Open house, delicate matter. Mr. Throgmorton asked me to find out what happened to Herbert Glover, a collector of fine arts. He is located between Windhalf and Century Avenue. Lives on Goldbridge Road in central Old Grove. Okay, there's the bridge. And where was the location exactly? Between Windhalf. Here's Windhalf. And yeah, so he lives right about there. Cool. So I want your top hat. I really want your top hat. But it's okay. I guess I'll have to settle with, like, wearing the skin of my enemy. Sometimes you just gotta take a hit shot. That's all it is. You know, this is kind of a rather nice area. It reminds me a little bit of South Carolina. You know, other than that right there. Oh, please do not tell me that's where I have to go. Hey, so you have any idea what you saw up here? Nope, okay. Can I go in? No? Seems awfully suspicious, though, yeah? No? Maybe I can't go in yet? Ooh. Digging the fog, by the way. Alright, so between... Is that gonna be on this side, or it's gonna be on this side? Alright. Take it one house at a time. Oh, a white door like that looks awfully suspicious. Especially given the rest of the house. Why is the door fine, but the rest of the house is just decaying? That's not it. That's the one. Just in case. Nice place he's got. Okay, a little on the creepy side.
Why keep a 40-year-old newspaper article?
Francis Throgmorton, the city's darling scholar and adventurer, is once again an eligible bachelor. Further text, unreadable. Mr. Throgmorton, it's with the deepest regret that I must inform you that the price for the piece you have requested has changed once again. The demand for it has increased, and now it is tripled that which we agreed of earlier. I know this is the second time that I've raised the price, but extreme circumstances of the flood make each piece almost invaluable to me, as I cannot replenish my collection.
The door won't budge.
Let's go see if there's a key. Check the basement first. You know what? Let's try our new melee. Doesn't really work. Does that seem faster to you guys, or is that just me? Statue's head? Oh. Okay. Got a knock. Wait, did I ding? Oh, I dinged. All right, so, since I dinged, I think we start going for crafting. Make it easier to get additional brownie points. All right, let me check upstairs. We're looking for a statue without a head. Got a dead body. Question is, whose body?
Looks like they're short a full set. One of the mirrors was taken. What's that?
I don't know, but,
still wide open. Guess he didn't see the killing blow coming.
Don't worry, Chad. He's just sticking around. Goes in there. Anything out of the ordinary? Other than dead body? Ooh, it does look like the place has been searched, though. And ransacked.
These slight scratches around the keyhole. Whoever broke in knew how to pick a lock.
Okay, but what was in... Can I not open it up?
These slight scratches around the keyhole. Whoever broke in knew how to pick a lock.
I wish I could open it up to see.
Huh. That's a lot of warning shots.
Yeah, that's actually really weird when you think about it. He was stabbed, and yet they did multiple warning shots? I don't suppose he's married.
Yeah, you like what you see, buddy?
Squint, run! Oh, okay. I've killed him.
Easiest gig in this district. You grab the mirror. I'm gonna go see what other loot we can take from Mr. Moneybags here.
Who are you? What in K's name are you doing in my house?
Okay, let's see what we have here.
Okay, so clearly not warning shots. He just sucks at aiming. All right, so...
Who are you? What in K's name are you doing in my
actually,
house?
Actually, no, it would be this.
Easiest gig in this.
Who are you? What in K's name are you?
Squint, run! Oh, Kay, I've killed him.
Two men broke in to steal a mirror. One of them, Squint, cracked the safe. But Glover discovered him and shot him. Second one killed Glover.
Whoa! Job well done. All right, let's go put the head on and see if that unlocks the door. Oh, we break it.
The door won't budge.
Okay, but that put the head on. Do I have to fix the head? Is there any more heads I gotta turn? Oh, nope, door budges. Ooh, nice. Hang on. That's a medkit, right? All right, I'm just gonna pop this. And then we'll grab the other one. All right, so knowing what we know now, delicate matter, two men, squints, crudely drawn picture of a strange looking mirror. I'm thinking, who would work as a fence in this area? Or who could be a fence for this area? The best thing would be probably to check with the police department, right? Look up anyone with a history with Glover and Squint. Alright, so it's popping up one over here. Okay. But it has one over there, too. I don't suppose that's the one I'm looking at. Hope not. All right, let's go to the police department. I think that might be the best area to go to and be like, hey, so, not supposed you have to know anyone with criminal background. Squint. Very specific name. Gotta find a squint, a snitch. Where's the, archives? Back here. Huh? Where is archives? Crap. I walk by it.
Don't waste my time.
Such a nice guy. All right, we're looking for, I would say, property crimes. Suspects. Criminal pattern? No. Okay. How about we go? Let's go misdemeanors. No? Instruments of crime? No. Go violent crimes. Criminal pattern? Documentation? Two men broke in. One of them experienced a thief nicknamed Squint, proceeded to crack a safe. We have crime. That'd be a misdemeanor, right? Actually, let's go with standard complaint. Suspect. Instruments of crime. Really? That's not gonna give it either, huh? Let's see here. So it is a research. Not his first robbery in the district of... Ah! Okay, so let's go... Property. Old Grove. Suspects. There it is. Philip O'Connell, alias Squint, male, age 46, residence unknown, crimes, newest burglaries in Old Grove, breaking, entering, tax evasion. Possible associate, Sydney Stokes, 21, Oakmont, Massachusetts, Northern Salvation Harbor, west of the intersection of Moreland Road and Salvation Road, crimes, jaywalking, lollygagging, jury duty dodging. What is lollygagging? I have never heard of lollygagging. Wrong way. All right, Fade, you take it easy. Thank you for stopping by. I'm gonna figure out what's lollygagging. All right, so he was located on Oakmont, Massachusetts, Northern Salvation Harbor. What's the intersection of Moreland Road and Salvation Road? Okay, so Salvation Harbor, Moreland, and that's Marsh, Maple. Yeah, there's Moreland. Hey, there's a little place right here. Okay. Moreland and Salvation. Oh, do not tell me it's like right there. It might be right there. Cool. The art of choking someone to death with a lollipop. Ah, got it, got it. Violent crime. Very violent crime. Shame on him. Apparently not his first crime. Definitely not a misdemeanor. What? Are you saying you lied to me? That's like loitering. I figured as much. I figured it was like, because they're like jaywalking. It's like, oh my god, he's a jay. Mr. Stokes, the price for a separate burial for your mother, Martha Stokes, is 30 bullets. More cannot give you a discount. There are more requests for burials than we have resources or manpower to satisfy. Must make the payment in 2 weeks, or we will give you but to intern your mother in a mass grave.
I'm happy to say I've never been hungry enough to consider eating whatever this is.
Oh my god, that's the crustacean in the cat. Oh. Ew. That's nasty. I'm sorry, did you just try to boop my snoop, buddy? Nobody boops my snoop. I'm the boot snooper. Looking around. It's upstairs. So we have motive, which is kind of sad. Ooh. You know, I'm actually almost willing to pay the bill.
Looks like Squint was
on this guy.
A bad day. Survived getting shot just to be stabbed to death. But who did it?
I take it Glover? Because Glover was the only one that survived, right? There is something supernatural occurring, though. I hear the whispers.
Oh, Ma. I killed him. What have I done? What in the world have I done?
Something. There it is.
At long last, I'll fix what that old ape lover Francis did to you.
Okay, that took a weird test. I follow the birdie.
Hark! Get away from the... Oh, thank the gods. I thought you were another monster.
Does everyone know magic here, or is it just the frickin' Innsmouthers? Sydney Stokes.
Sydney Stokes, I presume.
That's right. Do I know you?
Don't think so. I'm here about Herbert Glover. I believe you know him. Or, should I say, knew him.
Okay.
How'd you get in here?
Nice trick with the wall. How'd you manage it?
It wasn't me. She put the wall there with some kind of hocus pocus.
And who is she?
You said she put the wall here. Who is she?
She's our employer. I don't know her name or anything. She promised us a good payout for a simple job. And I fell for it like a chump.
What was the job?
What did she hire you to do?
The job seemed simple enough. Go to the collector's house, grab some fancy mirror, and then hoof it out of there.
So where's this fancy mirror now?
She took it. When me and Phil met her with the goods, they got into a big blowout and she shivved him. Okay, what am I to do now? Phil was the idea guy. I'm just a sap.
Come on, paint me a picture. What did this woman look like?
She was tall and thin, very thin. Just skin and bones. Mean like a rattlesnake. That's all I can remember. I didn't look too close at her.
Were you hired to kill the collector, too? Or was that just for laughs?
I swear to Kay, it wasn't part of the plan. It was an accident. The guy started shooting at us, and I panicked.
You panicked? Really? That's your excuse.
Oh, please, as Kay is my witness, I didn't mean to kill anyone. I'll give you everything I have. Just let me walk.
Well, you've had quite a night. Break-in, theft, and manslaughter? I'm gonna have to report this.
Please! I'll get the char for this!
You should have thought of that before you killed a man.
Wow, it's an entire, like, section of the room! I really need to know how they do that, because that is a nifty trick. All right, now we have an unknown. You know, I think that was the woman that was crying about the boy. And if that's right, that means that his hired help, like the nanny, killed the guys. And the nanny apparently knows how to do magic. She was right here. Where'd she go? I'm more than positive it was the hired help. Or, like, somebody close to him. There's an unusually large amount of vegetation in this area. I get it. 8, but still.
The door won't budge.
Let's try the basement. Basement looks like shit. Good news though, that's a nice pool table though. Give him that. Two of them aren't around. Damn it. Then again, it might have been his wife.
I've looked into your delicate matter.
Excellent. Don't spare me any details.
Glover's dead. He was killed by a man named Sidney Stokes who happened to be robbing his place. He wasn't working alone. He had a partner, Phil O'Connell. Didn't end up much better. All over some kind of mirror, apparently.
Truck. Where is the mirror now?
Their employer has it. Some mystery woman. I didn't get her name, but she obviously wasn't fooling around.
I see. So, my enigmatic competitor has finally shown her hand. And the thieves are both dead, you say?
Sidney Stokes managed to make it out in one piece. Now, if I had to guess, he's probably holed up at his home. Want the address?
I would welcome it. I'll take pleasure in, educating him on some, shall we say, essential truths.
All right, I've held up my end of the bargain.
I feel like there might have been a little bit of a turn. Bad option.
Of course, Mr. Reed. Here's your payment. Now that you know everything, would you accept the second part of the job?
Let me guess. You want me to track down the mirror?
Yes. And the one who so rudely snatched it from my grasp.
Why not?
I'm on it. Only got one lead, though. Our culprit had a bone to pick with someone named Francis. Mean anything to you?
Ah, yes. That is, without doubt, my father. Francis Throgmorton. Gay rest his soul.
What's he got to do with this?
I found mention of the mirror in his records. That's what led me to take interest.
Did he have any enemies?
Your father was a prominent man. I'm sure he had enemies. Anyone come to mind?
None who would outlive him.
You mentioned your father left records. Mind if I take a gander at them?
The prospect of you rifling through my father's possessions does not fill me with joy, Mr. Reed. But if that's what you need, so be it. Take this key.
Ooh, okay, we are gonna call it.